Hello and thanks for watching AUXIF New York. I'm joined by Mark Billings. He's the president of Auxico Resources Canada. Mark, very good to meet you.
Good to meet you too, Stephen. Thank you for your time today.
You're welcome. So for viewers not familiar with the company, can you tell us about Auxico?
Yes, Auxico, we're listed on the Canadian Securities Exchange. AUAG is the ticker. And over the past couple of years, Auxico has assembled an interesting portfolio of properties in three jurisdictions that are in the critical mineral space. We have a property in Colombia, the monastic property in the Eastern Department of Bichada, that has a host of rare earth elements, as well as tantalum, niobium. We also found platinum and gold. So it's very polymetallic. And we've done recently completed a number of pits on the property, sampled them, and we hope to codify the resource estimate in a technical report sometime in the fall. So we have our mining permit from the National Mining Agency, and we hope to bring this project into production, hopefully in the very near future, once we get the resource estimates and share that with the public. A second property that we've accumulated over the past little while is in Brazil, in the state of Rondônia. We have a joint venture with a company called Simal. It's a cooperative there. And this area of Brazil had historically produced tin. And so over the past 50, 60 years, a lot of the tailings have been accumulated on the Massangana property in Rondônia. And a study was done by DERA, which is the German mining ministry, and the Brazilian Geological Survey, and looked at how those tailings could be monetized. And essentially, they basically presented a business plan, a feasibility study for us, outlining that we can produce a number of concentrates from this tin. Obviously, we can produce a tin concentrate. I'll talk about that in a second. We can also produce a columbite concentrate, as there's tantalum and niobium in the tailings. There's also a zirconium concentrate, and finally, a monazite concentrate hosting a number of rare earth elements, including neodymium, lanthanum, gadolinium, and so on. So we have this joint venture with Simal, and we hope to put this property, the tailings, into production in the very near future. That's one of the key things that the company is focused on. And if you looked at our recent press release, we announced the signing of an offtake agreement with a company called Cuex, and they're a Swiss commodity trading firm backed by, they're essentially the Swiss operation of a Chinese firm that is very big in the commodity space, particularly in tin. And our hope is from these tailings that we can produce these various concentrates. And there's a lot of interest in the tin right now. And that deal is worth about 18,000 tons of tin over the life of the contract. And that the value of that is about $330 million US. And that's and Stephen, that's one of the offtake partners we have. There's three or four others that we're in discussions with. Cuex will take about 60% of the projected production of tin, and our hope is we'll get other offtake agreements, signed in the near future, and they will of course be announced. Auxico is also we have a sister company, Central American Nickel, that is active in the Congo, and we have an agreement between the two companies, whereby Auxico is the exclusive sales agent for the rare earth concentrates that Central American Nickel has in the Congo. And we've begun to sell rare earth concentrates. We've done two shipments representing about 300 metric tons. And we hope to get another shipment done in this month of August and another one in September, and eventually ramping up to about 1,000 metric tons a month. So I think it's one of the unique things about Auxico is that, we have these properties and they both have merit in Brazil and Colombia. At the same time, we are producing and selling rare earth concentrates with Central American Nickel. And so we're in the game of selling these commodities, which as you and people watching this know, it's a very sensitive industry right now, given that the markets are dominated essentially by China and all of the Western countries, particularly the United States, are looking for diversified supply sources. And that's easier said than done, because there's really no serious production outside of the United States. So our goal as Auxico is to be a player in these strategic and critical minerals. We have this property in Colombia, as I said, which is very rich in a number of these minerals, the rare earth elements, but also tantalum and niobium, and we have gold and platinum, and that'll be codified into a technical report very shortly. The Brazilian tailings are, that's something that we have on our front burner right now. I'll be going to Brazil in a couple of weeks to get everything going, a meeting with our local partners. We're going to be planning the CapEx and the equipment that we need to purchase to get into production. And having those offtake agreements definitely helps. And in terms of capital raises, if we have those agreements and we're signing, I mean, Cuex is a very large organization. It's very well known in the commodity space. And by having agreements with that kind of quality of customer, should help us raise the funds necessary to get Brazil into production. Another asset of the company is we have, over the past 5 years, worked with a technology called ultrasound extraction. And the analogy is quite simple. If you have a kidney stone, which I hope you don't, but if you do, you go see your doctor and they will basically pulverize the stone into smaller fragments so that it'll pass through your system. Using that same technology, we pulverize the ore using ultrasound into smaller fragments so that the minerals can be liberated quickly from the ore in a more efficient and a more environmentally friendly fashion. So we've had patents for this technology. We've tested this technology, and we're able to extract the rare earth elements from the ore. And in some cases, we have thorium, which is a radioactive element, and that can be extracted. And that was one of the key issues for the Brazilian tailings, is that there is thorium content. So by using that technology, which we've tested over the last 5 years, we have patented, we're getting excellent recoveries, we're getting these critical minerals into solution. So we have secured over the past couple of years a significant amount of real estate in terms of these critical minerals in Colombia and in Brazil. And just as importantly, we have a processing technology that will enable us to harvest these minerals from the ore in a very efficient, environmentally friendly, and economic manner. So I think that's the compelling thesis for Auxico. That's why we're excited as a company to move forward with all these projects, and at the same time, cash flowing the company with sales of rare earth elements from the Congo. That demonstrates that we have a product that the market wants. And I think we're in a very good space right now. It's a very interesting one. Very strategic one. The Canadian government just announced in the budget earlier this year $3.8 billion of funding for the processing of critical and strategic minerals. That's something that we're looking seriously at, and hopefully that we'll get a piece of that pie to move forward with our business plan, which will be eventually the production of pure rare earth and other strategic elements from Auxico. So step by step, we're getting there. A big step has been taken in terms of being a player in the rare earth markets. We'll move forward with the Brazilian project in terms of getting those tailings. And we have, as I said, a tremendous amount of interest. Just for the tin alone, we have 4 or 5 offtake partners in Cuex. They've committed to taking down 60% of the projected tin production. And we have other elements, as I said, columbite, zirconium, and eventually the rare earth elements. And of course, Colombia will move forward. And we're in the final stages of getting the samples. They are in the lab. We'll get the results and interpret those and codify that into a resource estimate for our shareholders. And all of that will be in a technical report. As you can probably understand from this conversation, we are pretty busy at Auxico. It's never a dull moment. And we have a pretty ambitious plan, but we think we're in the right space. And we have a great team that's supporting us, great partners, great offtake partners as well. And it's just an exciting time to be there, and we will move forward.
Sounds like an exciting time indeed. I hope you'll keep us posted on any progress. Thank you very much for the update today, Mark.
Thank you very much. Yes, we will keep everyone posted. As I said, there will be more offtake agreements, more news releases, so stay tuned.
Mark Billings is president of Auxico Resources Canada.